Hello and welcome to my channel. This is My Life for IR, and today I'm showing you once again the lens I just got for my GH5. This is the 17 to 70 mm f/2.8 to f/4 lens from Sigma. Beautiful, very modern design that looks really nice on the GH5. And I thought it would be much larger than this size, but actually it comes with this very nice manageable size. And it is much smaller than, for example, the Sigma 17 to 50 mm f/2.8 lens, which I assumed it would be that big, but it is not. To my surprise, to my pleasant surprise, I really like the size, the look of it, the build quality of it. So I'm gonna make a video, a whole review video, to talk about everything about this lens, from image quality to bokeh, to all the nuances about the mechanisms, the zoom rings, focus rings, and the switch buttons, the AF, MF, OS, all those nuances. And I'm gonna talk about some very interesting, weird facts about this lens. There's some problem with the aperture; the camera doesn't read the aperture properly. So instead of a variable aperture, the camera reads the aperture as a constant f/2.0, which can't affect your exposure when you're using auto exposure, because the camera reads f/2.0 at 70 mm, while physically it is f/2.8, so the camera will underexpose the image for you. So that you have to keep in mind. You have to, you know, compensate manually when you're shooting at long end, when you zoom into 50 mm or 70 mm. You have to remember that you will get underexposed image unless you manually adjust, you know, compensate for this mistake by the camera. I don't know what is the cause, what is the reason that it doesn't read properly. Might be because of the Viltrox adapter, the speed booster not working properly, the communication is not working properly, or it could be the firmware update was not up to date. Maybe it's an old one. Who knows? Maybe one day I'll figure it out. I already posted a question asking if anybody knows or understand why it is so on Reddit. Hopefully we can get an answer, and if I get an answer, I'm gonna obviously post down here in my next review, big review video. I'll try to save all the points from for the review video instead of just talking all on this video. So as you can see here, I have the script written here already, so no spoilers. But just to let you know that I've been working on a big review from the very first day I get this lens. So I'm planning already what to talk about this lens, what to shoot, what kind of sample image, what kind of sample video I'm gonna get. Trying to make a really good review video, and hopefully we can get a very nice video, because I searched a lot about this lens and I don't get much results. Like if you search on YouTube, you search Sigma 17 to 70 mm f/2.8 to 4, you don't get many results, and most of the search results are very old, like 3-4 years or 5 years old, really old videos, not up to date. And generally they were using the, you know, Canon native mount. So there I found only one or two videos talking about adapting this lens on GH5. So I'm gonna be the second or the third one, and I don't know where it's gonna put me in terms of an algorithm, because it's such an overlooked lens. Like even if nobody else is talking about it, I doubt that I would get many views, but it's worth a try. I mean, I personally like this lens. I like the design, I like the idea about it, but I don't know why it is not so noticeable. Like people just don't talk about it, people just don't want it, or I don't know, it's overlooked. In my opinion, it's underestimated. But we'll see. I'm gonna bring it in the real life to test it out anyway, so you will see for yourself as well. And I'm gonna try to shoot as many photos and as many videos as possible before I actually finalize the review to present you the most, you know, all around everything, every information, every bit of information, every bit of material I can gather for you to provide you with a informative, you know, informative suggestion or advice as for if you want to buy this lens yourself or not, or maybe you just want to, you just a gearhead just like me, you just like watching review videos just like me. And hopefully that can satisfy your curiosity as for how well it performs in various different situations and different circumstances with a different combo and in different settings and whatnot. Anyway, let's talk about the form factor first. Just quickly talking about the form factor, I just want to mention that it is really nice, manageable size, as I said before, and here you can see it compared to A7S II with a Tamron 28-75mm f2.8 lens. They look pretty similar, like in terms of the size and weight as well, because the A7S II is a little bit lighter than the GH5, I believe, and in turn the lens is a little bit heavier than this lens, so in the end, kind of balanced out. I don't really remember the number, but in my impression, it is so. But in the end, they are pretty much the same weight and kind of similar in size as well. The GH5 is a little bit bulkier, and A7S II with the Tamron lens is a little bit long. It's kind of, I don't really like the long. The lens is so long that protruding so much. And when you're shooting vlog, for example, you're holding in your hand and shooting selfie style, and it just looks a little bit absurd, and the balance is not really nice. So I would prefer something like a shorter lens like this one. This one, it is a little bit shorter. It's much shorter if you don't take into consideration the speed booster. So the lens itself is much shorter than the Tamron, obviously. But with the speed booster, so they altogether, it's gonna be a little bit more similar in terms of size and weight. And if you take off the lens hood, actually, it'll look even smaller. So, and let me just show you some other lenses that I have. You can see the sizing comparison, just how big, how small it is. This is the Lumix kit lens, 12-60mm, 3.5-5.6 lens, really tiny, small lens. And when you put this on the GH5, it weighs nothing. It's really convenient. You can carry it anywhere you want, and just wonderful combination. But I wanted a faster aperture. That's why I got this lens to replace it. Speaking of replacing, I don't think it's gonna 100% replace this lens, because I still need this lens. For example, when I shoot sports, when I shoot. I record my tennis sessions, so tennis training, tennis matches, tennis games. I prefer using this lens. Why? Because it's autofocus and it's much easier. It's lighter for the tripod. I don't worry as much as using this lens as well. So yeah, this autofocus works very well when you're shooting wide. So yeah, it's not gonna 100% replace this. Also, because this one has a little bit longer range. Up to 60mm, so in full frame term is 120, and this one's up to 70mm, which is 100, about 100 in full frame. But anyway, I'm gonna do a test, a comparison between these two lenses to see the image quality difference, how do they compare, and also probably I'll test the focal range between these two as well, just to see how do they compare, as well as maybe I will test the bokeh between these two as well. Now I'm going to show you another lens that is also a smaller lens. It's also from Sigma, 30mm f1.4 lens. This one is native designed natively for Micro Four Third, or rather designed natively for APS-C, and they happen to design a Micro Four Third mount as well. So f1.4, a really fast, really nice, beautiful lens, and this lens is also smaller. So I would say the Sigma, if you know, the Sigma 16mm, it's larger, longer, and that one is probably the same size as this one. But 30mm is just a little bit tinier. And 56mm is even tinier, is even smaller lens. Yeah, cool. F1.4 is significantly faster than most of the other Micro Four Thirds lenses. But this one is up to f2 at a wide end. And when you zoom in to 50mm, it becomes f2.8. So if you compare that to f1.4, it's two stops slower. So it's quite a big difference, actually. Yeah. But at f2, the difference is not that huge. But on the other hand, it is at a wide end, so you don't see the bokeh anyway. Or rather, you don't see it that much, that obvious, because of the compression. So yeah. Next lens I'm going to show you is the almost dropped it. It's a Sigma 10-20mm f3.5 lens. This is an old style, very old design, a classic design Sigma for Canon lens, and it's kind of a bulky, heavy. Especially when you put it on the speed booster, it looks really big and heavy. And together with GH5, it's just a really big combination. And yeah, it's a little bit just too heavy for my taste to shoot vlog with. I kind of just use my kit lens 12-60 to shoot vlog right now. You know, when people are talking about vlog lens, like people always think of ultra wide 10-20mm, 10-18mm, 10-22mm, these kind of lenses. But in my opinion, vlogging lens is something, you know, all around. Like you can get wide and you can zoom in as well, because vlogging, you know, you're walking on the street, you're traveling, maybe you want to shoot selfie style, but you don't want to have, you know, look at your own face all the time. You want to focus in the background as well. If you see something interesting on the street, you want to zoom in, you want to be able to separate the subject, to pick out the subject from the background. And that's why I think a standard zoom lens is perfect for vlogging. That's why a vlogging lens should start from at least 12mm in Micro Four Thirds, or rather 24mm in full frame terms. And the Panasonic has very good vlogging lens that is 20-60mm for their full frame lineup. It's very interesting design, very unique, and other manufacturers don't do this kind of lens from 20mm that's approaching ultra wide. And I think that would make a very nice vlogging lens, because you can get a very nice ultra wide angle look when you point it at yourself, and then you can zoom in at 60mm. It's decent. You can really separate the subject, so I think that would be a ideal lens for vlogging. So that's just my opinion. Anyway, comparing these two lenses, as you can see, this is much bigger, bulkier, and also heavier. What else to say? It's f3.5, so it's kind of middle of the road. It's like between f2.8 and f4. So this is actually pretty fast as well with the adapter on the GH5. So another thing I want to mention is that the GH5, well, all the native lenses, if you compare the native lens to this lens, for example, this is f2.8 to f4, which behaves like f2 to f2.8 lens. Well, yeah, there are so many pro lenses, like a 12-35mm f2.8. 12-40mm f2.8. Those lenses are across the range are f2.8 only. And here you get f2.8 only at the long end, and you get f2 or f2.2 or f2.5 and before 50mm. So that means this is quite a bit faster than even the fastest standard zoom lenses, professional level standard zoom lenses in Micro Four Thirds lineup. So it's really good. And if you compare this to Leica, I'm gonna talk about this again in the review video, but right now I'm already talking about it, but whatever, it's okay that I'll repeat myself in the future. Well, if you compare this to the Leica 12-60mm that for a while I wanted really badly, that is f2.8 to f4 as well, but it's a whole stop slower because it is native Micro Four Thirds lens, and this is adapted with speed booster, which means at f2.8 is f2, you know, one stop faster, and f4 becomes f2.8, and again one stop faster than the Leica lens. So really, I just I just thought, okay, in the end, I just realized it doesn't make sense to get a Leica lens that is one stop slower and costs twice as much as this lens. So in the end, I just decided to go for this lens instead. So that's my thought process and why I got this lens, and just my first impression on the and all I can think of for now. And yeah, this is what I wanted to share. And actually, let's zoom in these lenses. I'll show you the size comparison when you zoom them in. And another thing about this lens is that the zoom ring, the direction is reversed from most of other lens design, so it's a little bit weird. I don't really like that, but it's fine, I don't care. And this is the kit lens. When you zoom in, the kit lens zoom in, you get quite larger, but still it's very small, light, plasticky, and plasticish kind of a build, so super light. And you can see the comparison between these three lenses. There you go.